Hello, this is Lightning Loaf 9, and I am drawing Pokemon and turning them into monsters, even though they're already monsters, but turning them into scary monsters, if that makes any sense. Probably doesn't. It's alright, you guys will get it once I start drawing. So, why am I doing this? Well, it's almost Halloween. It's October anyway. And it's not almost Halloween at all. But it's October. Oh no, what's happening? Yes, Origin. Yes, you can install. I don't care. Even though I'm what am I doing? I'm recording. That's what I'm doing. I am very tired because I just came back from school, but this is the only time I get to record ever. It's very bad. And I don't remember anything of what I was supposed to say. I planned an intro and everything, and it just all went out the window as soon as I clicked 9, which is my record button. Alright, so I was going to play a horror game and record it, and I did that 3 different times with 3 different games. And the first one was, well, I'll let this little clip from the game show you how that game was. Boring! Moonshadow, you agree this is boring? Of course he does. Yeah, it was very boring. Anyway, after that one, I played a game called Price, which was about a boy and a girl, and they were brother and sister, and one was Ivory and the other one was Iva, and then, I played it. I completed it. It was only like an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours at the most. It was free on Steam. And the problem with that game was I had only 2 recordings, right? They were both like about an hour each. And the first one was okay. The first one was great. Perfect. Except for a bit of loud music in some places. Second one, I tried to fix that, which I thought the music quality was very good on the second one. There was just one problem on the second recording, and that was that my voice was gone. Bandicam had decided, for whatever reason, that it would be a perfectly okay thing to do to turn off my mic. Let me make sure my mic is on real quick. Is it? That's not. What? There we go. Mic is perfect. What did I just click there? Oh no. I got rid. It doesn't matter. It's still recording. We're good. So I can't really upload a silent video, if you know what I mean. Nor can I replay that and recreate the funny stuff. Whatever the funny stuff was. It wasn't really funny. All you missed was me calling a caterpillar a caterpie about 2 times in a row, and I was laughing at myself for about 3 minutes straight on that. And then later I played piano. Those are the only cool things you missed. Oh, and in the third game, you did miss something there. You missed a bunch of stuff falling on me in the third game. Frick! Oh my god! What the heck? This freaking thing's head just popped off! Dialga fell on me! This thing fell on me and its head broke off! And my hat fell on me all at the same time! Right then! Why? It was great. The third game was a game called Go Away Bandicam. Jesus. Wait, actually, come back! Oh! What did I click? Are we still recording? Okay, I have no idea what the heck just happened. I clicked something. Anyway, where was I? Enigma. The third game was called Enigma. I know this is a very long intro. I'm gonna try and cut it as much as I can, but I'm only one person, and I'm not very good at editing or anything. Anyway, Enigma. The family something. Illusion is family or something. I don't remember. It was like $5 on Steam, and it was the one that I played the least amount of time. I only played it for about 30 or 40 minutes before quitting. And, I can't explain why I quit. I just quit. It wasn't scary. It didn't make me, like, quit because I got too scared. No, I was laughing the whole time. I mean, I can show you guys parts where I was just laughing, bursting out laughing. I bent down and reached out to the moist floor. And then I smelled the unidentified liquid at the tip of my finger. Why would you need to... What? You have a match! You can just look down and see that it's red. You don't have to touch it and smell it. What? What am I doing? Is that me hiding? Oh, that's adorable. My instinct was crazily shooting out the signal of danger to all nerves in my body. Ack! Erp! Let me do the worm backwards, okay? I was about to shriek. Oh, no! Oh, frick! Ah, no! Hey, I'm... Get away! Go away! Go away! Go away! Go away! Go away! You're scaring me! You're scaring me! Go away! Ah! I'm dead. I think I quit because I knew it was going to be very tedious. And it was going to be very tedious because the whole entire game is basically you trying to run away from some guy while finding out the story of what happened to these people in this house or something. And I just didn't want to do that because that sounded boring to me. Anyway, god dang it, watch. I quit all of that. And I decided, you know what, this isn't a gaming channel. Why am I trying to play a horror game anyway? No one wants to see that. Except maybe a bunch of you. So instead, I'm gonna draw Pokemon while talking about drawing Pokemon. And I am the worst commentator in the world. And I haven't even started drawing. That's how bad I am. Oh man, I can't even draw a Caterpie. I don't know why I chose this Pokemon. I guess I thought I could draw it, but I can't. You know what? I'm gonna draw it differently. It's gonna not stand up like that. It's gonna slither like this. Yeah. That's not right at all. Caterpie is one of my favorite Pokemon, and the reason why I'm drawing a Caterpie, I'm not sure if I've already told you guys why I'm drawing a Caterpie, but I'm drawing it because of that time in Price when I called a caterpillar a Caterpie twice, which I just told you guys about. So right now I'm just drawing normal Caterpie. He's not looking scary at all. It looks like he has boobs for hands, but that's alright. That's normal. I almost drew those hands wrong. Legs. Why am I calling them hands? I don't know. Anyway, this looks wrong. This looks terrifying already. Maybe I should have drawn a Pokemon that I know how to draw instead of one that I don't know how to draw. You know what? This looks actually pretty good. I said it was ugly, but now I kinda am okay with it. Now I'm gonna add the scary parts before finishing this entire thing. Instead of this cute little adorable pink Y shape, or T, whatever, I'm gonna make it a horn. just a big horn. Right there. No. Even better, I'm gonna make it antlers. Yeah. Antlers. How do you draw antlers? I have no clue. I'm gonna guess they look like that. And I have no idea how to draw this one over here. But that's okay. It's good. It looks great. And now for the nose, we draw a circle. Then we draw another circle. I have the worst commentary in the world. But hopefully I'm skipping through the boring parts, or I will be skipping through the boring parts later. And then we give him some angry eyes, because that makes him scary. And fangs. Everything scary needs fangs. Perfect! And now these pathetic little wimpy legs that look like boobs, they just go away. They go away and they become knives. Okay, these aren't really knives, but they're triangles. And triangles, as we all know, are the shapes of evil. So that's why I'm drawing triangles for legs instead of circles. Because circles are peaceful, but triangles are hardcore. There we go. Okay, and now we, instead of the circles on the side of him, he gets triangles. Lots of triangles. It's starting to look like Illuminati, but that's okay. I can't really draw triangles because my brush is too big. And there you go. That's Caterpie. Now to color him. To color him. We did that. Now we add the green. This is all horrible green. You know what? I'm just gonna do that. Oh, yeah, that green looks very nice, very, very good and scary. And then instead of pink, we're gonna make it red, the color of blood. Because as we all know, blood is the liquid of evil. So, darn, why can't I color this one in? Is there a hole that I'm not seeing? I don't see anything. What the heck? There we go, I colored it in. Okay. And now, instead of a nice yellow eye, we're gonna have a... Actually, we're just gonna keep it yellow. We're gonna have a yellow eye. And why is this not green? There we go. And now, the stomach, of course, is gonna be yellow. Oops. And that's gonna be yellow. And, that's gonna be yellow. See, in my head, this looked like 10 times better, but it just came out looking really ugly. I'm gonna try harder on my next Pokemon that I draw. Okay, that took me about, what, 6 minutes? I don't know. How long was my intro? My intro was about 12 minutes, so I'd say this took me 1 minute. That's such a lie. There we go. I did a scary looking Caterpie. Why is that black? Why is that gray, not black? There we go. His fangs connected. And that needs to be erased in there, because that's gonna give me... There. Aw, darn. There. I wonder if I can... Whoops, nope. 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 I can't zoom back in. Okay. What? Now that we've drawn a Caterpie, it's on to the next Pokemon. Let me go find it. I'm gonna do Numel. 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 Kept spelling Numel wrong there, but that's okay. And why am I doing Numel? Because Numel is my spirit Pokemon. And why is Numel my spirit Pokemon? Even though I called him Numel when I was a kid? Well, because Numel is the oblivious Pokemon. And as you all know, I'm pretty oblivious to everything. So that's why I'm gonna do Numel next. I don't know how the heck I'm gonna make this guy look scary, but I'm gonna do it. And you guys are gonna watch. It's probably gonna be sped up because I actually want to do a good job on this guy, and that requires concentration. And concentration for me requires not speaking.
Stories on the radio, bad news on the TV, headlines are made up reality. Where young hearts look at us go, all we really need is a stereo. Where young hearts...
Oh yeah, this is Numel. Goth Numel. Goth Numel. I don't know why I made him goth. he just kind of became that way. I was like, what's a scary Numel? Well, instead of the one big ol' eye, you just cut that in half, and bam, he looks angry. You make him frown, you cut open his ear a bit, you give him spiky hair, and you make him have a mountain on his back instead of a volcano. And that gave me this guy, who I don't even know what to call. You know what? This looks kind of like it could be an Aloha. What is it called? Aloan? Alola forms. Did I say that? No, I think I said Aloha and Alolan. Alola. It looks like an Alola form, just because of how different it is from Numel. But I don't think it really looks very tropical or friendly like Alola forms are. But, I don't know. I think I can see Team Skull having this guy on their team. Maybe. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna go do the final Pokemon, which I don't even know what it would what it should be, because I haven't gotten this far. Well, I didn't think I would get this far, anyway. I don't know what to do. I'm thinking Skitty, just because I see a Skitty right here. But, no. I already did Hoenn. I already did Kanto. Let's do a Johto Pokemon. Quick, Johto. What's the first thing when you think of Johto? For me, I thought of Pichu. And then before Pichu, I thought of Manaphy. But then I was like, no, that's not a Gen 2, that's Gen 3. So, Pichu it is! How on earth am I gonna turn this cute little adorable mouse into something scary? I don't know, but looking at this very shiny picture kind of gives me an idea. A very terrifying idea, but an idea nonetheless. That's a really good drawing, by the way, whoever drew that. There's lots of good drawings here. Let's draw a scary Pichu. I don't know how I'm gonna do this at all. Cue the music. All of you are thinking, as you're watching me draw this, I know you're thinking, why, Lightning? Why are you drawing this? I don't know. I don't know. It's sort of just the first thing that came to my mind, you know? I don't know why. I don't know why this monstrosity came into my mind when I thought of a monstrous Pichu. It just sort of happened. And, you know, when things happen, I just let them happen. Oh no. Why did I do this? Well, there you go. It's Scary Pichu. Now I'm gonna color him some great colors. I'm just gonna color him the same colors, actually, because I think that would fit nicely. Oh, I forgot his pink cheeks. Oh well. I'll just add those in right now. Make them splotchy. Perfect. And then we just add a bit of highlights. Like that. And there. And there. And there. And all around here. These aren't even looking like highlights anymore. They're looking like spots. That's okay. We don't judge highlights around here. Then we even do the hands. And then we get gray. And we do the ears. You know, he kind of looks like a melted gummy bear. I kind of want to eat him. I don't know why. He just kind of looks like something that would be delicious. Oh no. Should I even try doing highlights on this part? I don't know. Probably not. But I'm gonna keep doing it. There you go! There's Scary Pichu! I don't know why I did this video. I don't know why. I have made so many monstrosities today. In only 26 minutes. So let's see, what did we have first? Caterpie? And the reference for Caterpie is gone because it's covered by that Numel and I'm just lazy. Okay, there we go. So there's original Caterpie. And there's Monster Caterpie. Looks horrible. Terrible. Next up, Numel, which we have right here. He's my favorite of the three, by far. And then we have Pichu, who is my second favorite. Who's melting, and I don't know why melting is considered scary in my mind, but I guess it is. I don't know, he kind of looks more like Muck's adorable cousin, but there you have it! Pokemon drawn as scary, weird creatures, because they weren't really scary, they were more just weird. I forgot what I was gonna say to do the outro. Oh yeah, I commentated, sort of, kind of, whenever I wasn't in my tired phase, because I just came back from school, and that's the same thing as not sleeping for 3 weeks. I wish I could have done an animation instead of drawing these monstrosities, because, well, an animation would have been more entertaining, probably. Wouldn't give you nightmares, like this is gonna give me nightmares. But I don't have the time, unfortunately. Anyway, this has been Lightenwolf9, drawing Pokemon and commentating to my drawing. That doesn't make sense. Commentating while drawing. There we go. Thanks for watching.